seated. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Officiant Catherine Mundy, and it's a joy to be here today with Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis on this their wonderful wedding day. Dearly beloved, we've gathered here to celebrate one of life's magical moments. We welcome together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to acknowledge and strengthen a bond that already exists. Let this be a day of happiness and celebration for Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis as they are joined together today in marriage. Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis would like to honour the memory of those who couldn't attend. Kalita, Francis, Frankie, Dave, Pete, Edith, and Robert. To the side of us here is our memorial candle. And this has been lit, keeping the light burning in remembrance of those loved ones who will live on in our hearts and minds today and always. So what is love? Love is a song that never ends. Love is a promise that is always kept, a fortune that can never be spent, a seed that can flourish in even the most unlikely places, and a radiance that never fades. This mysterious and magical joy is the greatest treasure of all, one known only by those who love. Just like Piglet once said, the Winnie the Pooh. How do you spell love? And when he responded, you don't spell love, you feel it. You see, once in a while, right in the middle of an ordinary life, love gives us imagination that has no age, and dreams that last forever. But most importantly, love gives us a fairy tale. It's a tale as old as time, and true as it can be. Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis' story began in Eastern Kentucky University, on the second day of classes, in August 19, 2014, at McGregor Hall, and it was plain to see they were connected, as by September 5th, 2014, they'd already started dating. And as time went by, it became crystal clear they'd fallen in love. And so, on Labor Day, September 3rd, 2018, Jordan Chase asked Lauren Francis, parents, Michelle and Keith, along with their granddaddy Keith, for their granddaughter, Lauren Francis' hand in marriage. And they all said yes. And with lots of happy smiles, they were engaged. This love has opened a whole new world for them, with new horizons for them to pursue. Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis, your deep connection as true soulmates shines brightly in the world. And it is a powerful blessing and possibility to everyone around you. As a soulmate, it is a remarkable role to play in someone else's life. You see, a soulmate is someone who has locks that fit your keys, and keys that fit your locks. When you feel safe enough to open the locks, our truest selves step out, and we can be completely and honestly who we are. We can be loved for who we are and not for what we're pretending to be. Each unveils the best part of the other. No matter what else goes wrong around us, that one person we're safe in, our own paradise. So our soulmate is someone who shares our deepest longings, our sense of direction, and our soulmate is the one who makes life come to life. I have something that you've said about each other that you sent through to me when we were talking about homework. And this is what Lauren Francis loves about Jordan Chase. He's so shy around people, but when we're alone together, he can be his true self, act silly with me. He is so true to himself and tries to make everyone happy, even when it is at the risk of his own happiness. He cares about things so different in ways that people wouldn't expect, and he shows them in different ways. And this is what Jordan likes about you, Lauren. There are many things I can say that I like about Lauren. Her smile when I have a bad day. Her laugh when I could tell the worst joke possible. A similar interest, taste, that shows more and more each day we're meant to be together. The list could go on for ages. I can't just narrow it down to a few things. Everything she is and everything she will be as my future wife is what I love about her the most. She is my future, and if I have her until the end of time, I know that my life will be amazing. It means more pizza nights together, more nap times together, where she sleeps while I just stare at her and think, how did I get so lucky? More traveling the world together, and hopefully with a bigger family as time passes. This marriage could not come soon enough. Jordan Chase and Laura Francis, today you begin a new chapter in your storybook. You are entering as individuals, but you will be leaving here married, blending your lives, expanding your family ties, and embarking upon the grandest adventure of human relationship. The story of your lives together is still yours to write. I want you to both look at one another and remember this moment in time. For now, you shall say a few words that will take you across the threshold of life. And things will be different than they were before. But after these vows, Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis, you shall say to the world, this is my husband and this is my wife. I need to look at Lauren and repeat after me. I take you, Lauren Francis Clark.
I take you, Lauren Francis
Clark. To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
In the presence of our family and friends.
To the presence of our family and friends.
I make you this vow.
I make you this vow.
Lauren Francis, having heard Jordan Chase's vows, do you now take him as your husband? I take you, Jordan Chase Pooch. To be my lawfully wedded husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse.
For
richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. In the presence of our family and friends. I make you this vow. Jordan Chase, having heard Lauren Francis vows, do you now take her as your wife? As part of today's ceremony, Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis have chosen to symbolize their relationship through hand clasping. In Celtic lands such as Scotland, Ireland and Wales, it was formally recognised handclasping as a marriage, just as binding was long performed in a church. The ancient practice of handclasping gives us the phrases we all know today, like tying the knot and the bonds of matrimony. Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis, woven into your marriage ribbons are all your hopes, your love and your dreams. The colours that you chose of orange will offer you encouragement, attraction, kindness, and plenty. Red gives passion, strength, lust, and fertility. While pink offers unity, honor, truth, and romance, but above all, happiness. The attached charms are lucky talisman. One of them that you chose specifically was pizza. So pizza will ensure plenty of happy nights and date night. Your Cinderella castle symbolises your home as your own magic kingdom. Mary Poppins shows even the impossible is possible. The cat is a symbolic of rebirth and resurrection. Pets like cats have 9 lives. The rose will give fragrance to your love and will blossom as long as you believe. And the aeroplane will offer a life of travel and adventure. While the Celtic knot ties you together as a couple, the infinity knot symbolizes eternity and everlasting love. At this point, I will be calling upon members to come up and tie their ribbons. I'm going to start with Mum, Mike, Michelle. Putting new ribbons onto the actual marriage ribbons gives it more meaning. So we'll begin with the blue, which gives tranquility, patience, devotion, sincerity, safety, and strength. Yellow offers charm, confidence, joy, and balance. I'd like to call on Dad Joe David. Green offers finances, fertility, charity, prosperity, and health. Purple offers power, piety, sanctuary, and sentimental. Round out of 10. You'd like to come to this side? Black offers strength, wisdom, vision, and success. White offers purity, concentration, meditation, but above all, peace. That peace. Brown is an earth and grounding colour, offers talent, telepathy, and home. Grey is a neutral and cancelling colour, which will offer balance to your marriage. And finally, Mum Tracy. Gold offers energy, wealth, intelligence, and longevity. And silver will offer you treasures, values, creativity, and inspiration. Jordan Chase. And love and Francis. You two are intertwined in love, bound by all which brings strength to this union. Hold tight to one another through good times and through bad. And watch as your strength grows. The knots of this binding are not formed by these ribbons, but instead by your vows. For as always, you hold in your own hands the making or the breaking of this union. Therefore, always remember, as you look at these hands that hold today on your marriage day, these are the hands of your best friend, willing and strong and full of love for you. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours still giving you the same tenderness in every touch. May I have the rings, please? Rings are an ancient symbol of unity and completeness. As day follows night and night follows day, your two lives begin a new circle of life. Let them be a sign that love has a presence as well as a past. And may these rings remind you always of the vows that you've both taken here. Today, I marry my best friend and soulmate.
Today, I marry my best friend and soulmate.
Lauren Francis Clark.
Lauren Francis Clark.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
And promise to make each tomorrow.
I promise to make each tomorrow.
The best it can possibly be.
The best it can possibly be.
Today I marry my best friend and soulmate.
Today I marry my best friend and soulmate.
Jordan Chase Beach. I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
And promise to make each tomorrow.
And promise to make each tomorrow.
The best it can possibly be.
The best it can possibly be.
Yeah. Now. You'd like to interrupt the pinky fingers. It's time for one of the most original forms of remembering a promise that cannot be broken, and that is a pinky promise. So I want you to both look at each other, repeat after the same time, at the same time after me. I pinky promise.
I pinky promise.
To be your best friend.
To be your best friend.
And your snoobable.
And your snoobable.
And to always,
and to always,
and
forever,
be
yours,
to infinity and beyond,
to infinity and beyond.
Jordan Chase and Lauren Francis, as you embark on your new married life together, built on the foundations of compassion, trust, and friendship, may the love that you have expressed here today grow in time into a legendary tale. Full of happiness. May the inward aspirations of your hearts be the outward reality of your home. And may your home always be a magic kingdom, but full of light, truth, beauty, and of joy all the days of your life. And may you both live happily ever after. Jordan Chase. Lauren Francis. As you have pledged your vows, and are consented to be wed to each other, and have consummated the celebration with the giving and the accepting of the wedding ring. By virtue of the authority vested in me under the laws of the state of Florida, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your beautiful bride.